Now let's get ready for the next bout of the evening. It's going to be a super bantamweight contest over 6 rounds between Abdul Aziz Seidu from the Akotoku Boxing Gymnasium and Eric Tete is coming from the Palm Spring Boxing Gymnasium. Now officials for this bout: Judge 1, Michael Nikwe; Judge 2, Mimisa Akako; and Judge 3, Ishmael Williams. The man in charge of this fight is David Mills. Shall we please welcome the boxer from the blue corner, from the Palm Spring Boxing Gymnasium, Eric Tete.
Ooh, baby, you know we outside. Yeah, yeah, we outside. You know we outside. Champagne for my pain. I stay in my lane. Every day is my birthday. Wait till we get champagne for my pain. I dare you, my lane. Every day be my birthday. Like a panda, the way she move it make a panda. Break it down, make it wiggle like a panda. I want to know what you make me in the corner. Bouncy, 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 baby, bouncy, 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 baby, bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. Champagne for my pain. Another banger, baby, calm down, calm down. Yo, this your body, put in my heart for lockdown.
Ankara is still here with us in commentary position, together with DJ NY, and we'll be walking you through the fight night. It's fight night 17. Cross-section of the fans here, and I must say that we give a big thanks and take our hats off to the partnership between IMAX Media Promotions and the Ghana Boxing Authority. Derek, you have been part of the continuous build-up, and from the last fight night 16, and tonight's fight night 17, we don't want to go back to what really happened, but obviously it looks like the GBA has worked hard with IMAX Media Promotions to ensure that at least the rest of the fight nights that we have in front of us will be incident free.
Well, I think that we must say kudos to the GBA and IMAX Promotion for the work done. If you go out, you see the kind of security that has been provided because of what happened the last time. There's a lot of security around, and I'm so happy that our dignity, especially the foreign dignities, are here today. It just goes to confirm that they are okay with what is happening today, and I'm happy. The fight is going on. We've just seen the second, a very good fight, and I think nothing will stop the IMAX Promotions and GBA from putting such a league together. It will continue, we'll end it, and then it will start the next edition. And having learned our lessons, I believe the next edition will even be better than what we are currently seeing.
Okay. Looks like we are getting ready to get the boxers into the ring for the next bout of the evening.
We have one of our heavyweight boxers who is here with us tonight, a former WBO heavyweight champion for Africa, Ibrahim Nilate Harrison. Harrison is here, so I just want to invite him to the ring just in a minute or two. He was banned for 5 solid years by the Ghana Boxing Authority by the Iswar former GBA president Peter Zuenis. He's almost served over 3 years now. The ban has been lifted. He's here with us tonight. We want to hear from him whether he's excited, whether he is going to correct some of the abnormalities that caused the ban or what. Shall we please welcome the boxer, Harrison Nilate. Harrison Nilate is one of the finest heavyweight that Ghana is looking forward to see him get into the top. But due to some skirmishes, he was banned for 5 years, but it has been lifted. Now he's a free man, and we hope and believe that is gonna change things around. You're welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Harrison, you look big. You know, you've dwarfed me. I'm looking like a very short person. How are you, sir?
I'm doing good by the almighty grace. And you know, in the heavyweight division, you have to come out big and strong.
Okay, very well. Now, when the press release from the GBA got out to the media was super excited that, look, you're one of the boxers that you've penciled down to become a world champion for Ghana in the heavyweight division. When you were banned, you were very sad. Now everybody is happy. Now tell us, how do you feel by lifting this ban?
I feel very great and strong as a new leaf who is about to update his career again. And I thank my fans and everybody who support me in the days of my trial. They all supported me very well, both in prayer, spiritually and physically. I thank everybody supporting this occasion. And the GBA, the current GBA president is doing so well with the IMAX Boxing Professional Boxing League that I'm here today to tell them a lot. But well, I can't tell all, but just have to tell them kudos to everybody who supported me through my trial and my sanction days. I'm back, the new Latte, son of the eagle, Okropon, be Okropon. We live, long live Ghana, long live Ghana Boxing Promotions.
Now that is very exciting. Now before you take leave of me. Now, your former manager, Ivan Bruce-Cujo, I know he's watching us live, and there was something that went under the bridge. Would you officially apologize to him and Kabik before you take leave of me?
Okay, if there is no mistake, there is no correction. We stand to correct ourselves in so many ways. I said, if I step on anybody's toe doing my days with Kabik Promotions and others, I'm please sorry.
Sorry. Shall we put our hands together for him? Now, finally, when are we going to see you coming back into the ring?
Like, first, I'm supposed to fight in Tanzania, which happens to be my second home. But as of now, home sweet home, so I'll definitely make my comeback over here in the boxing arena very soon. But yet to be announced my opponent.
Thank you very much for coming. Very well. So that is Arezin Nilate. The ban has been lifted. It's now a free man. And we hope Ghana Boxing Authority and those who are behind him will support him to become a world champ. Now let's get ready for the next bout of the evening. And this is going to be a super bantamweight contest over 6 rounds between Abdul Aziz Seydou and Eric Tete from the Palm Springs Boxing Gymnasium, Aziz from the Akotoku Academy. Now, shall we please welcome the boxer, Eric Tete. So now we have the boxer Eric Tete. So shall we please welcome Abdul Aziz Seydou?
This year they go play one of our guests. Next year they go open new chapters. We don't get time for the designer clue, so we show boxer.
What's up?
Call over Luffy Nani. Abu Mario. T Young.
So we are ready for the next bout of the evening. This is a super bantamweight contest over 6 rounds. Now, officials for this bout: Judge 1, Michael Nikwe; Judge 2, Miminsana Kakpo; and Judge 3, Ishmael Williams. Now, introducing the boxer fighting out from the blue corner, and this evening is spotted in all white trunks, black and white shoe, and yellow gloves to match. This is the man with a weight of 123.70 pounds from the Palm Springs Boxing Gymnasium here in Accra, with the official record of 3 fights, 1 defeat, 2 wins. This is the man who was born and bred right here in Accra at Jamestown, presenting to you the boxer, Eric Tete. Crossing over to the red corner, spotted in the black and white trunks, black and white shoe, yellow gloves to match tonight, with the weight of 121.50 pounds from the Akotoku Academy. This was the gymnasium that nurtured, groomed the likes of Azuma Nelson and Ike Basuka-Kote. This is the man who is making his debut today as a professional boxer, presenting to you the boxer, Abdul do. And the man in charge of this fight is David Mills.
David Mills, center referee for this bout, is just about getting ready to issue the last set of instructions to the two boxers before we hit the road running. Super bantamweight contest scheduled for 6 rounds between Akotoku Academy's Abdulaziz Seydou and Palm Springs' Eric Tete. Promises to be a very interesting bout. Abdulaziz Seydou is making his debut, professional debut tonight. Tete has fought thrice, won two and lost one. Special thanks to everyone who's watching us from across the world. And let me say a very, very good evening and thanks for making time to watch all the way in Namibia. Matchmaker Mubarak, who's almost always with us here in commentary position, is watching the fight night live in Namibia, somewhere in Windhoek, I must think. And the good news coming from Namibia is that we are very soon going to be seeing John Quay in action for the WBO title. Details will be coming up later. Anyway, let's get back into the ring, and it's Tete Tete in the white, Abdulaziz in the black. And Abdulaziz, I must admit, came into the ring looking very, very unassuming. Of course, his debut appearance in the professional ranks of boxing. Trying to open up there, Abdulaziz. His opponent, Tete, looks a bit quicker of the two. And he's the heavier of the two, Tete, coming into the ring at a weight of 123.7 pounds. The wild miss there from Tete. Not too sure what he had planned to do there, and is given an opportunity to Abdulaziz to see whether he can break the guard. Good enough for the debutant so far. And Tete tries to close in. Going for the wild punches, missing. And then going in for the clinch. Comes forward yet again. Abdulaziz fighting out of the renowned Akotoku Academy, an academy or a gym that has produced world beaters. Tete trying to duck most of the blows that come his way, and then tries to go in for the in-house. Well, it's been a very good enough opening round for both boxers, especially Abdulaziz Seydou, who's making his debut as a professional boxer, DJ.
Prince, that was a good first round from both fighters, but I must commend the debutant, that is Abdulaziz. I mean, as you said earlier on, he was coming into the ring, was kind of, you couldn't know whether if this kind fighter can do justice in the ring, but you know, he has kept it simple so far in round one. What he's doing is that he's really relying on his long hands. So the long range fighting style is what he's doing right now, as that is Abdulaziz. What he's doing now is making sure that Eric Tete is not getting closer to him. Because as you said earlier on, Eric Tete has that forward thrusting that if you give him that chance, then it's going to hurt you. Abdulaziz has been smart enough in round one. He has noticed that Eric Tete have that kind of possession in him, so he's making sure that he doesn't get closer to him, and by so doing, establishing the jab is what Abdul has done so far in round one.
Here we go, action in round two, scheduled for 6, this super bantamweight contest. Abdulaziz in the black and white trunks, taking on Tete Tete. He's in the all white. And Tete now trying to take the fight to Abdulaziz. Tries to go in for the uppercut. Aziz, that doesn't work. Tete trying to score a couple more points with the body jabs. Good one to the head of Tete.
And Prince, we might see Abdul Aziz getting into trouble, because now what Eric is doing is forcing Abdul to fight. And Abdul too has noticed that he's trying as much as possible to swerve himself away from that danger zone. But Eric is still probing to make sure Abdul comes into the inside game and fight.
Yes, it looks like Tete is sending the fight to his opponent now. Tries to work on the body, some hefty punches going in there. David Mills watching closely. Keeps coming forward, Tete.
Prince, is the reason that Eric Tete keeps coming forward is that Abdul Aziz punches is not getting any significance on Eric Tete, should I say, because if a boxer is punching and you could see that the opponent is still coming through in that punches, that tells you that the punches are not having any worry on that boxer. So I feel Abdul Aziz punches should be a little bit heavier so that when it hits Eric Tete, he can feel it. But Eric Tete is not feeling anything. He's still coming forward through those punches.
Yeah, I see him taking all those punches in his guard. Lots of instructions coming to Abdul Aziz from his corner. Don't forget he's making his debut in the professional ranks. Tete clearly the aggressive one in this bout. And the bell goes for the end of the round. Now, Derek, I don't know whether the tactic is a very good one being employed by Eric. We saw his tactic in the first round, but it looks like after the bell, they came in for the next round. He's been more of the aggressor and trying to be the explosive one.
Well, I see two different fighters or boxers. Eric is a fighter, and Aziz Seydou seem more of a boxer. He box, he wants to have that comfortability to fight. But Eric, seeing that Seydou has a lot of things better than him, better reach, better height, and then is a bit faster. He has decided that he will not allow Eric. Have decided that he will not allow Seydou to take on his toe. So he's been chasing him, and that is the difficulty Seydou is having in the ring. But I think that the number of ring experience that Eric has had is telling on the game. As much as I believe that Seydou has won both rounds, he's not getting it easy at all. And if he doesn't take care, by the third, fourth round, he will be worn out. And Eric, with a strategy, can win the fight.
Eric will continue.
He has a lot of energy. Mm.
Continuing with that explosive nature of his, Eric. And Abdul goes for the clinch. A fighter that he is. Eric is not scared to come forward. Good shot to the head, and Abdul
Prince,
still stands tall.
I think Seydou is not doing that well. He has a reach. I don't know why he's also trying to go in fighting with Eric
whose advantage is in the infighting.
Yeah.
Because he's not afraid of the kind of blows Seydou is throwing at him. So he chases him. If you are such, you have such a long reach, what you have to do is to do the jabs, move to empty spaces, and have control over the game. But I don't know what the problem of Seydou is.
Obviously willing, roaring, and ready to go. Eric Tete Tete. And a little bit of a caution there from David Mills, our center referee. Let's get on with it, he says. Well, although he may be the explosive type, Abdulaziz is also working his way, clawing back the pride and gaining a little bit of a intimidatory escape route, as it were. Eric not giving up, clearly.
Prince, in as much as you look at Eric having a lot of experience, but Seydou is giving Eric a lot of tough time. You could see that what Derek said, Seydou is relying on his longer reach. What he's doing now is he punch jab, make sure he probes with a jab, then he moves away, intimidating Eric. And Eric is always coming forward. What I'm afraid for Eric is that he might be coming forward thinking he can eat the blows of Seydou. But one punch, one counter punch, if he doesn't get that defense well and it hit the chin clean, we might see Eric hitting the canvas. What Eric needs to do now is make sure getting the inside game and get an override hand that if it can hit Seydou's chin, because Seydou, what he's doing now is trying to toy his opponent, and in so doing you can get your defense open, and if that counter attack override hand gets it clean, then you're gonna have yourself being punched clean.
Well, clearly we are trying to tell a story here of Ghana boxing, its development, especially through the promotional rounds. Again, another round that clearly saw the aggression of Eric Tete Tete.
Yeah, I mean that is what his advantage is. He must chase Seydou for Seydou to get frustrated, so he gets the right punch that will take him down. But he's doing it. Unfortunately, when he gets Seydou is quick. So you throw the blow and Seydou will also dodge and then clinch. So Seydou is doing something alright. As much as Eric is chasing Seydou, he must be tactical and ensure that the kind of blows that he throws will get to Seydou. Other than that, we'll be throwing blows which are unnecessary. And that will not score him a point. And he might lose at the end of the day.
Round four it is in this bout, scheduled for 6. And Eric Tete Tete is looking so, so confident. Let's see how the last two rounds will go in this bout. Bell has gone already. Lots of feedback on social media. Looks like everybody seems to be interested in wanting to know more about the WBO fight, which is being worked on, I should say, for John Quay. John Quay has been one of the best prospects we've seen in the Deluxe Professional Boxing League. And already, that's a WBO Africa title in the offing for him. Matchmaker Mubarak Yusuf Nano, watching closely from Namibia, where it looks like the good work done by the Ghana Boxing Authority under Ibrahim Nikwe seems to be blossoming like wildfire. And sooner rather than later, we will see John Quay, a product of the Deluxe Professional Boxing League and managed by IMAX Media Promotions, get a shot at a title. It's a tough battle in the ring now, as both boxers would not want to give an inch. Tete still comes forward, riding on that high level of confidence of his. One will get the feeling that with this explosive nature of Tete, tiredness will start creeping in. It's just the fourth out of the sixth round, or out of six rounds. Tries to go in there once again. Carefully planning out such a strategy that he gets into trouble, he clinches. Abdulaziz still stands tall. Now a give and take affair. And the neutral corner. What did he wait for on that occasion?
Prince, the fight is really getting intense there. You could see that Eric Tete is growing out of frustration. And Seydou is really loving it. But what Eric needs to know is that as he's getting in confidence and growing in confidence, Seydou is really, really reading him very, very well. And any defense error that Eric does, Seydou is capitalizing on it. Eric knows that now that it stands now, Seydou is winning by points. So he's really, really much the aggressor as compared to Seydou. But I mean, Eric, sorry, Prince, this fight is really getting intense, and I feel Eric Tete needs to tweak his tactics going into the next round, because what I've seen so far, he has given Abdul the benefit of the doubt that he can really match him up, in as much as he's the debutant, but he's really fighting as if he has been in the ring for some time now. And I must commend Abdul so far, what he has done, incredible performance he has done so far in the rounds.
It also looks like Tete has not been too clinical with the punches.
I must second on that. He's rushing. Yeah. He's rushing. And the reason he's rushing is that he knows that Abdul is winning by points. And he knows, just look at this. He thinks the punch is not really having significance on him. Up. But hey, you have judges there. Second judges are scoring up by points. Any punch round that hits you clean, the judge is going to score you by points. And I feel Eric Tete should know this better than anyone else in the ring. So he should be much as possible, make sure his punches are really hitting clean, or else Abdul is going to take away the points and Eric might be furious. But that is how boxing is. Boxing is combat sport. You need to score points by doing what? By punching clean. And if Eric is throwing punches but is not hitting clean, then I bet he should tweak his tactics going into these rounds.
Here we go. Round 5 is scheduled for 6. Super bantamweight contest between Abdulaziz Seydou and Eric Tete. Tete. Abdul has done pretty, pretty well, I must say. Making his debut appearance tonight. Tete in white. And with a dyed hair. The aggression seems to have gone down a few notches from Tete.
Well, Prince, I feel what Eric needs to do now. He has tried as much as possible to go in upstairs of Seydou's face. But what he needs to do now, tweak it a little bit. And what I mean by doing that is go to the body of Seydou. You know, as we started, I've not seen Eric attacking the body of Seydou. And that is something we want to see. Eric needs to attack the body of Seydou. And let's see if Seydou can handle the body punches from Eric. If he still goes to the upstairs, Seydou is still going to toy him, move around and jab and make sure he collect points from the punches as hitting clean on his opponent.
Tough fight it has been, this one. Tete still comes forward. Abdul clearly is now losing gas. Just walking across us here in commentary position is George the Red Tiger Ashi. Won the Africa Boxing Union Super Featherweight title, the UBC Super Featherweight title, and Commonwealth Lightweight titles. Was also a challenger for the WBA International Lightweight title when he fought against Emmanuel Tego, and a Commonwealth Super Featherweight title contender against Kevin Mitchell. And again goes in for the clinch. And clearly, Abdulaziz, at this stage, he needs to keep his balance, keep his momentum, trying to toy Tete now into making mistakes and then trying to nip him. That's a wild miss there from Tete. From what we've seen in the first five rounds of this contest, do you expect an explosive last round?
Oh, yes, yes, especially on the part of Eric Tete, because you could see out of the five rounds, I could see that Abdulaziz has done significantly well for me, a debutant, and is really fighting toe-to-toe. You know, Prince, what he's doing is just simple. Stick to your basic boxing fundamentals. And what he's doing is that he hits his opponent and makes sure he does not get hit. You understand? And that is what is making Eric find it difficult to get a clean punch on Abdul. Abdul is relying on his lengthy hands, his reach, and his height. And that is really, really causing a lot of progressive nature on the part of Abdulaziz. From round one to round five, I've not seen Eric really doing something that has really caused Abdul to even, I mean, have a G3 or kind of have a wobbly leg. What Aziz is doing now is trying as much as possible, stay on his toes, and make sure if the opponent is coming in an inside fighting game, he counterattacks him, use the jab to probe him and blind him so that Eric does not have any significant thing to do. Round six up your way, and let's see if it's going to be explosive one.
Well, it's the sixth and the last round in this Super Bantamweight contest is scheduled for the first six rounds. Connoisseurs of the sport have done a lot of talking as the boxers go in. Now it's a give and take affair. And Tete fighting so very hard, trying to keep his flow and his momentum. He's not interested in the clutching again from Abdul. And referee gives him a warning. He comes forward once again, looking very bullish at this stage. But I must confess and I must admit, he's missed most of the blows he's thrown.
You see, Prince, that is what a lot of fans here are not really noticing. They think the swinging and hands of Eric Tete is really scoring something.
Yeah.
But that's what I keep saying. Judges are there. They are really watching the kind of punches that are hit and clean. You can be swinging and the fans will be cheering you up. But ask yourself, are you hitting it clean? If it's not hit clean, judges are not going to score you. So he needs to make sure what he's throwing and swinging is hitting clean on his opponent to score points.
It's the sixth and the last round of this bout. And Maya is getting interesting as we get to the end. Into the corner they go. There's a brief clinch. Clinch has worked quite well for the debutant, Aziz Seydou. And I'm sure at certain stages, Tete would look quite and seem frustrated by virtue of the fact that he's not getting through, he's not landing the big ones, and all his opponent is doing is trying to buy time by going in for the clinch. Well, he lands a big one now, Abdulaziz. That's good enough. Tete, that's a clarion and a wake-up call for him. Keeps coming forward, though. ducking here and there. He misses a wild one, Tete. Misses again. Misses a third time. And Abdul does well to claw back some pride. Fans will urge him on. Abdul is now on the offensive. Tete seems to be in trouble. He's at the receiving end now. Good punches from Abdul Aziz. Wow.
Prince, I must confess, that is smart and intelligent boxing from the debutant, Abdul Aziz. 3-4 combination and they are all hitting clean. You ask yourself, Eric Tete, what have you done so far to hit clean in this round? The debutant so far has done the best performance I've seen tonight.
Couldn't agree with you more, especially the last round. Quite a tactical switch by Abdul Aziz on that occasion. Suddenly opened up and we saw the punishment he gave to Eric Tete. And again, from the replay, clearly shows Tete had his moments, but when Abdul opened up, he was in trouble.
You see, they always say that boxing is an art. And you see, Abdul has really shown that Eric has the experience. But you know, boxing is an art. When Eric had his moment, he was swinging wild, but he was missing.
That
Abdul had his moment, you could see his hitting clean. And you could see that fans were really cheering him up because what he was doing was paying a lot of significance on his opponents.
All right, let's go to Mohamed Amin Lamptey for the official verdict.
His boxer should get ready for the next bout of the evening. Musa Lawson from the Sonia Boxing Gym and Evans Owari from the Panix Boxing Gym should get ready. Very, very interesting bout. We are now waiting for the verdicts.
Coming up next is one of the boxers who has also endeared himself to the fans here, Musa Lawson. He fights out of the Sonia Boxing Gym. And he's taking on Evans Owari. Evans Owari is from the Panix Boxing Gym. Highlight of the night, by the way, will be Fit Square's Elvis Ahoga taking on Samson Amwak of the gym. That is expected to be a cracker.
Prince, I love that boxer, Elvis Ahoga, aka Buffalo Soldier. I mean, that guy, when he's coming into the ring, you should fear him.
Now we all
right,
the
over to Amin Lamptey now.
Are you ready for the verdicts? Are you ready for the verdicts? Now put your hands together for the boxes. Let's put hands together for them. Now, Judge 1, Michael Nikwe, scored about 59-55. Judge 2, May Mensah Akako, scored about 60-55. Judge 3, Williams, scored about 60-56. So, by a unanimous point decision, presenting to you the winner, ladies and gentlemen, welcome the boxer, Abdul Aziz Seydou. That is very interesting. Abdul Aziz, congratulations.
Thank you.
How do you feel?
Oh, I feel great.
You feel great. It was many Yomo or your can have fans here.
Minda, if I say French, Mofia and Babi and Niba support me. Minda Mofia Amoshi. She can clean on, can she have coaches, can manager. Minda, I'm a French.
Thank you very much. So, thank you very much.